Hyderabad Metro Rail project is an important initiative to reduce traffic congestion and reduce pollution levels in Hyderabad city. Initially taken in three corridors, we will cover 72 kilometers of the most congested areas of Hyderabad city in this project. There are three corridors: Miapur to LB Nagar is corridor 1, it's about 29 kilometers. Jubilee bus station to Falaknuma is 15 kilometers, and corridor 3 is from Nagol to Shilparamam, which is 28 kilometers. These three corridors together cater to major needs, transportation needs of Hyderabad city. This particular project is going to completely transform Hyderabad, as we have studied about 200 metro projects in the world, and the best features of different projects in the world we are taking and incorporating those features, good features, into this project. As a latecomer advantage, we have avoided the mistakes made by other cities, and we are taking the good features. That's how we are not looking at this project as a simple mass transit system, but making use of this project, how do we redesign Indian cities? How do we redesign Hyderabad as an eco-friendly, people-friendly, green city? So there are different novel features in this particular project. One is intermodal integration. What we are doing is the main rail stations of Secunderabad, Nampally, Begumpet, Malakpet, etc. We are integrating all the major bus depots of Hyderabad city, including Miapur, Jubilee bus station, MGBS, which is an interstate bus depot. All these bus depots we are integrating. We are also integrating important MMTS stations, which are the local railway station, local rail network. So with all this, it is going to give a good seamless connectivity. For this, we are also doing what is called the traffic catchment area. We have 66 stations at 63 locations. At all these stations, on the right side, how many colonies are there? On the left side, how many colonies are there? In these colonies, 15 to 20 colonies on both sides of the station, we will continuously run what is called merry-go-round feeder bus service. It's a good feeder bus service. So the main travel is going to be by the train, metro train, but the colonies are also connected. That's how, without need for any private vehicle, you can have your comfortable commute in the city. There are about 30 lakh vehicles in the city, and every year we are adding 3 lakh vehicles, private vehicles, per annum. At this rate, Hyderabad will one day come to a standstill, and the pollution levels become so high, so it will become no more a livable city. So this is the objective. With this objective, we are trying to create a good public transportation system which is affordable, which is world class, and which is accessible to all sections of the society. This is one aspect. And as I mentioned, we are also making use of this opportunity to completely redesign Hyderabad city. So we are going to create a number of facilities at all our metro stations. There are going to be bicycle stations where you can show your smart card, which is used for the metro ticket, metro train, and show this, then take a cycle out, go wherever you want to go, and give it at a designated place. This is one thing we are developing. We are developing skywalks. This concept I have picked up from Bangkok. We are going to create continuous skywalks below the viaduct, because ours is an elevated metro. Below this metro, this viaduct will be there. This skywalk will straight away land into schools, colleges, hospitals, residential, educational institutions, public offices, private complexes, etc. That's how we will make an efficient Hyderabad. People talk about Tokyo. Tokyo is supposed to be at three levels. One is an underground level, one is at grade level, one is elevated level, sky level. Similarly, Hyderabad is going to be one at the road level, one is going to be at the sky level. So this is how we have to make cities more efficient and more competitive globally. This is one concept we are developing. Similarly, we are going to have beautiful and quality public space at the metro stations. We are going to create good street furniture at these public spaces, so that top class facilities are available and people can come to the metro stations and depots, relax there without any problem. Another thing which we are promoting as a part of this project is promote family values. Good family values are required. Today, the rich people are not bothered about the children. What's happening to the children? We don't know. They're going into the hookah bars and getting hooked onto drugs, etc. The poorer sections anyway can't afford. They're busy with their day-to-day livelihood. As a result, the children are grown, they grow in the streets just like that. As a result, the crime rate is increasing. With this project, we would like to create quality public space so that all segments of the society, both the rich and the poor, can come to the metro stations, enjoy, relax, the entire family together. This is one concept we are developing. Like that, there are a number of other things. With these things, we are pretty confident that Hyderabad will become a modern city, a global city. Yes, we have to attract. We are a globalized world, actually. In this globalized world, you have to attract a lot of investments and a lot of talented and creative individuals, because these people are the creators of wealth in this what's called the post-economic era. This is the post-industrial era where the wealth is basically created by talented and creative individuals. This is how Hyderabad has to attract global talent, global investments, and should become a global destination, a good place for everybody to come, settle down here and thrive here. The project is proceeding pretty fast. We started about a year ago. Before that, for about 1 year, we were basically concentrating on designs and drawings without disturbing people on the roads. Later, when we were fully prepared, we started the work about a year ago. A lot of progress is there. Already about 20 kilometers, out of the total 72 kilometers, 20 kilometers in 1 year, we completed the foundations. In about 15 kilometers, we completed the piers or the pillars, and in about 5 kilometers, even that viaduct, that's a flyover like structure, is also completed. Now this month we are going to launch the rails on this viaduct. Then afterwards, electrification, signaling and other components also will come. This is how we are pretty confident that the whole project, it takes about 5 years. By 2017 we have to complete. The first phase of the project we will complete by 2014 December, that is next year December, and we will open up for public transportation as a Ugadi gift, a New Year, Telugu New Year gift in 2015 March. And the whole project, we are confident of completing it within scheduled time, that is in 5 years. That's one thing. And we are developing world-class facilities as a part of this project. For example, what is called CBTC, Communication Based Train Control System. This, for the first time in India, we are bringing in. Seeing that, this facility is coming up in Hyderabad. Now Delhi Metro also, in the next phase, they are going to introduce this CBTC technology. As a result of this, is basically radio-based communication system. With this, I have the capability to run in every 1.5 minute, that is every 90 second, I can run a train. Okay, this gives us tremendous advantage. To begin with, we'll run trains with 3 to 5 minute frequency during the peak hours, but later we can bring it down to even 1.5 minutes. With this, the public transportation capability and capacity in Hyderabad will tremendously improve. You people will have a very reliable system in this metro project. Similarly, we are also doing a lot of other activities. Actually, see, basically the kind of greenery which we are developing. For example, last year we planted about 60,000 trees and our survival rate is about 98%. Similarly, about 600 trees we translocated and all of them have survived. Similarly, this year also we are going to plant another 50,000 trees, and we are interacting with different segments of society. For example, this project, I'm looking at it to actually see what it can do for children, what it can do for women, what it can do for old people, and what are the special facilities that are required for physically challenged people or differently abled people. All these segments, we keep interacting with them. I conducted, for example, see what is called Nirbhaya commute, taking the experience cue from that Delhi's horrible experience, that even after 60 years of independence, women are not able to freely move in this country, in our cities. So we have taken that as an example, and on that basis we conducted workshops with our women groups. They came up with number of suggestions. They were very happy that actually we are incorporating all those safety features into Hyderabad Metro so that women will travel comfortably and safely. So similarly, we are also interacting with other social groups, and we are developing this project. This is, as I mentioned, there are about 200 metros in the world. Most of these metros are built by engineers as engineering structures of excellence. We are not looking at simple structural excellence, structural solution. Basically, a project will have to be created, a project like this will have to be created for the needs of the people, for the needs of the city. This is how, this is not an engineering paradise, but it is a people's project. It is a project that reflects the aspirations of the people, the interests of the people. That's how all the people were integrating, and we are involving them in the design process at different stages, and whatever requirements they indicate, they'll be incorporated into our designs, and we will make it a different kind of a project. With this, I'm pretty confident that the history of Hyderabad will completely change. There is going to be what is called a pre-metro era and a post-metro era. Post-metro era Hyderabad is going to be a world-class global city.